Hello, I'm Akemi Luisa Herráez Vossbrink, the Enriqueta Harris Frankfort Curatorial Fellow at the Wallace Collection. The Wallace Collection is home to an especially eminent collection of Spanish 17th century masters such as Velázquez, Murillo, and Cano, who are the usual focus of my studies. Today, however, I will focus on the Scottish artist David Roberts, the first professional British landscape painter to travel to Spain and Morocco in the early 1830s. Roberts started his career as a house painter in Scotland and as a scene painter for the theater, but later transitioned to sketches, watercolors, and oil paintings. Encouraged by his fellow artist friend David Wilkie, he set off for Spain in 1832, a country considered exotic at the time due to its prominent Islamic heritage in the south. Roberts toured the Middle East several years and had his portrait painted upon his return, wearing Arab-style clothing. This painting went on to be exhibited in the Royal Academy and helped fashion his reputation as a pioneering artist, traveler, adventurer. There are six oil paintings and watercolors by Roberts at the Wallace, representing various sites across Europe. I am going to focus on three of his Spanish and Moroccan works. The Spanish works include a watercolor representing a panoramic view of Santiago de Compostela and an oil painting of the Chapel of Ferdinand and Isabella in Granada. The third image is a watercolor of a rooftop view of the city of Tetouan in northern Morocco. Here you can see the three works, including two watercolors and an oil painting. The three representations are small in size and would have been worked up from initial sketches either taken by Roberts on site or by other artists. Starting with the oil painting, Roberts represents the entrance to the Capilla Real, or Royal Chapel of Granada, which is on the south side of Granada Cathedral. It houses the royal tombs of the Catholic monarchs Ferdinand and Isabella, who conquered Granada from the Nazarene rulers in 1492 and ended nearly 800 years of Muslim rule in the Iberian Peninsula. Robert stayed for 3 weeks in Granada, where he spent most of his time sketching the Islamic palace of the Alhambra alongside other picturesque views of the town. This painting was worked up in his London studio from sketches he had made in Spain 5 years earlier. The small figures in the foreground enhance the towering effect of the facade with its Gothic pinnacles. Some sculptures are visible, such as the angels holding the royal crest, and on the right, the Virgin and Child, under which we find the artist's signature. Interestingly, some of these sculptures appear to have been taken from other parts of the cathedral or have been imagined by the artist. The lower left-hand corner depicts a roughly painted market stall that is pitched in darkness, while on the right, there are men and women in traditional dress, a common feature of Robert's Spanish pictures. This scene is painted on mahogany, a precious tropical wood from the Americas. Painting on this exotic wood was more common in the 17th century and was revived in the 19th century. Suppliers who provided the wood also prepared the panels so the artist could paint directly onto them. This annotated sketch from David Roberts' record book indicates that this scene was painted for Elhanan Bicknell, a renowned art collector and ship owner involved in the whaling business. After his death, it was purchased for Richard Seymour Conway, 4th Marquess of Hertford, who acquired most of the paintings at the Wallace Collection. Roberts turned many of his on-the-spot sketches into watercolors in order to have them reproduced in Thomas Roscoe's 4-volume travelogue, The Tourist in Spain, which was published between 1835 and 1838. The 4th volume, titled The Tourist in Spain and Morocco, features two prints whose compositions were based on Roberts' watercolors that we house at the Wallace Collection. However, Roberts had not seen all of Spain because his own tour had been cut short due to an outbreak of cholera. As a result, he relied on drawings made by other artists or military officers to produce images for the parts of Spain he was unable to see for himself. This is the case with the watercolor of Santiago de Compostela in Galicia. Roberts relied on a drawing by Richard Ford, the renowned Hispanophile, who traveled extensively in Spain at the same time as Roberts, although the two only met upon their return to the UK. Ford took extensive notes and made many sketches of the places he visited. When visiting Santiago de Compostela, he drew the city from a distance, capturing a panoramic view with its great cathedral at the center. Ford also indicates the location of the seminary and the Church of San Francisco to the left. Roberts transforms Ford's view by adding color and defining the foreground area, where he includes a path used by the pilgrims heading towards the cathedral. He adds atmospheric touches such as the puffs of smoke from the chimneys that break up the skyline. This vista was then transformed into an engraving by William Wallace for Thomas Roscoe's The Tourist in Spain and Morocco. Uncolored, the composition loses the depth achieved in Robert's watercolor. But there were also individual colored versions of this engraving, which were sold separately. In the city of Malaga in southern Spain, David Roberts stated that, having seen Spain's marvelous Islamic architectural heritage, he wished to extend his travels to Morocco. Roberts' view of Tetuán, seen here, is based on earlier sketches he made during his excursion from Andalusia to Tangier and Tetuán in the spring of 1833. In Tetuán, he stayed in the Jewish quarter and sketched several views of the city from the rooftops against the Rift Mountains. In this instance, he captured a specific event, the marriage celebrations of the son of the governor Ashash in April 1833, which took place in the Grand Square and featured a jousting scene next to the governor's palace. In the foreground, there are rows of figures dressed in Sephardic Jewish costumes, painted with bright body color. Roberts enhanced the effects of color and light by adding varnish. This vividly colored panoramic vista appealed to Roberts' friend, the landscape painter Joseph Mallard William Turner, who greatly praised this scene. Like the image of Santiago de Compostela, the Great Square of Tetuán was transformed into an engraving to illustrate Roscoe's travelogue, where it complemented Roscoe's description of the event and the setting. Robert's travels in Morocco and Spain are part of a wider European fascination for exotic locales and foreign costumes, which is now known as Orientalism. While this interest can rightly be associated with Western imperialist attitudes, it can also reflect a genuine curiosity about the wider world and its many cultures. As a traveler and keen observer, Roberts was an important pioneer who set a trend for future artists. Thank you for joining. I encourage you to come to the Wallace to admire David Roberts' works and visually travel back to the 19th century.